Hello and welcome to Book Buzz. My name is Adam and I'm an adult services librarian at Napier Boulevard Library. My colleague Christy and I will be discussing exciting new books coming out this fall. This is a multi-part series, so we hope you'll check out the other parts to learn about different genres. In this episode, we'll be discussing crime fiction and nonfiction. The first book is A Slow Fire Burning by Paula Hawkins, out October 31st. This is the newest by the author of The Girl on the Train and Into the Water. In this one, a young man is found murdered on a houseboat. Three women with very different connections to the man are thrust into the spotlight. The book follows these women, their connections to each other and to the victim, as Hawkins writes with her characteristic twists, turns, and surprises until the thrilling conclusion. This is sure to be another hit for readers who enjoy Hawkins' brand of thrillers. Next, we have Rock, Paper, Scissors by Alice Feeney, out September 7th. This is the newest domestic thriller by Feeney that follows Amelia and Adam, a married couple trying to save their 10-year marriage. They go to a Gothic getaway in the Scottish Highlands, where they find a strange neighbor waiting for them. All three have secrets and ulterior motives for being there for the weekend. Feeney alternates between the three characters to uncover the motivations and secrets of each character. The twists and misdirection will keep you reading till the end in what has been called a craftily and cleverly plotted novel.
When Ghosts Come Home by Wiley Cash comes out on September 21st. This is a new novel by the author of A Land More Kind Than Home. This southern fiction mystery follows Sheriff Winston Barnes, who finds a crash-landed airplane with no cargo or pilot inside, but a man shot to death next to it on the runway. This book explores racial tensions in 1980s North Carolina, and Publishers Weekly says, "This rich, character-driven tale works best as a social portrait of a community and an era." State of Terror by Hillary Rodham Clinton and Louise Penny comes out on October 12th. Clinton teams up with Louise Penny, well-loved author of the Inspector Gamache series, to pen this political thriller. The new president has chosen a political enemy for Secretary of State, but just as he is about to address Congress for the first time with the Secretary of State in attendance, multiple terrorist attacks begin to take place. This novel is likely to be very interesting considering Clinton's background and the immense popularity of Louise Penny.
A Line to Kill by Anthony Horowitz comes out October 19th. This is the third in the Hawthorne and Horowitz series. If you're not familiar with this series, real-life author Anthony Horowitz has written himself into his murder mysteries as fictional Anthony Horowitz, with parallels to his real life, who pairs up with Detective Hawthorne. Think of Horowitz as Watson to Hawthorne's Sherlock Holmes. In this novel, they go to an island for a literary festival where Horowitz is promoting his newest mystery based on Hawthorne's detective work, when one of the sponsors of the festival is murdered. Despite the clever premise to this novel, the mystery itself is very much in the vein of classic Golden Age whodunits.
All Her Little Secrets by Wanda M. Morris comes out on November 2nd. This is a brand new legal thriller by a debut author. Elise Littlejohn is a black attorney with a cushy corporate job and is in a no-strings-attached relationship with her rich white boss. But then one morning, she walks into his office and he's been shot to death. Elise leaves without telling anyone, not wanting suspicion to fall on her and her past secrets to be exposed. When she's promoted to her boss's old position, she finds that things at the company are not quite what they seem and finds herself in a conspiratorial dilemma. This terrific new voice is getting a lot of advanced buzz. If you enjoy the legal thriller drama, you're definitely going to want to get your hands on this one. And now, let's talk about nonfiction.
Three Girls from Bronzeville by Dawn Turner comes out September 7th. In a memoir that Publishers Weekly calls beautiful, tragic, and inspiring, Dawn Turner recounts her childhood in the 70s, growing up in the historic Bronzeville neighborhood in Chicago's South Side. She follows what happens to herself, her younger sister, and her best friend. While they have an almost idyllic young life, as they grow older, their lives take radically different turns. She questions why the three of them, with similar opportunities and upbringings, moved in such different directions. Early readers note that the writing is as exciting as a novel, and they universally seem to love this beautiful and moving memoir.
Unearthing the Secret Garden, The Plants and Places That Inspired Frances Hodgson Burnett by Marta McDowell comes out on September 28th. Marta McDowell has written other books, some of which the library owns, about plants and gardening in different classic books. Here, the author tackles the inspiration behind Frances Hodgson Burnett's well-loved children's classic, The Secret Garden. This book is filled with photographs and illustrations, as well as lots of biographical details about Burnett's life. Publishers Weekly says that gardeners and book lovers alike will delight in this colorful survey.
Next, we have All of the Marvels by David Wolk, out October 5th. Writer David Wolk set out to read all 27,000 Marvel comics, and then he did it. And now he tries to make sense of it all in his new book, All of the Marvels. Wolk jokes early on in the book that not even the creators of the current Marvel comics have read all of the past works. Nobody is supposed to, which is why he decided to do it. He attempts to place the thousands of stories within a larger, overarching narrative, and in doing so makes the case of the Marvel Universe being one of the biggest stories ever told. This is a perfect book for comic book lovers or for people who want to know what all the fuss is about.
Taste, My Life Through Food by Stanley Tucci comes out on October 4th. This past spring, many people were watching the docuseries Stanley Tucci Searching for Italy, where the actor traveled across Italy, highlighting the various foods of different regions. Stanley Tucci, of course known for food-related roles such as Paul Child in Julie and Julia, now brings us this food memoir that looks at his life in terms of his food-related experiences. This is sure to be a popular title, so if you're interested, I would consider putting it on hold.